Bangerter Highway is a major north-south corridor, stretching from Salt Lake International Airport in the north to an interchange with I-15 in the south. Prior to construction of a series of Displaced Left-Turn intersections, DLTs, also known as Continuous Flow Intersections, or CFIs, Bangerter Highway experienced a high crash rate and severe congestion. One intersection alone averaged more than one crash per week. At some intersections, 25% of the signal time was devoted to left turns onto the minor roads, impeding both through traffic and traffic on the minor roads.
A local engineer put together a VSIM video of the 3500 South and Bangerter Highway location and said, this is the way this intersection will work with a continuous flow intersection. This is how it's going to work if we don't do this. And the difference was so striking to UDOT that they decided they had to learn more about this intersection.
Consisting of both two-legged and four-legged designs, the new DLTs along Bangerter Highway were designed to help alleviate congestion and improve flow. Let's take a closer look at Bangerter and 3500.
The location of Bangerter and 3500 South was experiencing a lot of congestion and multiple traffic signal cycle failures. So we built this location and watched it.
With the construction of the new DLT, travelers saved time and fuel.
We were able to build the continuous flow for about a quarter of the cost of grade separation.
Multiplied by 7, this is hundreds of millions of dollars in savings. But what about safety? Since construction, accidents within 3/4 of a mile of the intersection have gone down by 60%. And it's not just motorists that benefit. Pedestrian and bicycle accommodations were considered throughout the design process. Be it an overhead pedestrian walkway or a signalized crosswalk, non-motorized traffic can navigate the intersection safely and efficiently. Now, let's take another look at Bangerter and 3500.
We have a school that is very close to that intersection, and during the heavy times of school, we have as many as 140 children crossing that intersection. So we built our signal to account for pedestrians moving through the intersection. There's some refuge islands around the right turn signals, as well as provided striping for bicycle lanes through the area. So we've looked at Bangerter as a high capacity corridor north-south through the west side of our valley, and there were needs there. The continuous flow has really helped us increase capacity along that corridor by as much as 20% to 50% depending on the intersection.
So, what if you're considering building an alternative intersection design?
Anytime we introduce a new intersection, we cannot underestimate the need for public outreach and education.
Data collection is cheap, modeling is cheap. And so building good microsimulation models that have been calibrated and validated with proper data, field visits, really helps make the decision.
The Federal Highway Administration encourages communities and agencies to consider the displaced left turn, both to improve the safety and efficiency of existing intersections and as an option for new intersections. For more information about the DLT, and other innovative intersection designs, please visit safety.fhwa.dot.gov.